Na samom početku, u ime izdavačke kuće VDZ, pozdravih ovdje sve prisutne. Iznad mi je čast i zaista veliko zadovoljstvo što večeras ovdje u Lošinju, u ovom predivnom prostoru, imamo priliku predstaviti knjigu Crno more, jednog od najvažnijih, suvremenih škotskih autora, povjesničara i novinara Nila Ashersona. Da kako nešto više o samoj knjizi i autoru saznat ćemo kroz razgovor koji slijedi. Evo, na samom početku, Nil, pitanje, prošlo je više od 20 godina od objavljivanja tvoje knjige Crno more. Možeš li nam reći za početak kako si uopće došao na ideju da pišeš o Crnom moru i zašto baš o Crnom moru?
It has been 20 years since your book, The Black Sea, has been published. And how did you get the idea to even start writing about?
Well, there were three reasons. The first is that the Black Sea is extraordinary. It's not like any other sea. First of all, it is poisoned. Below about 200 to 300 meters, there is no life. This is because the water, and it's a very deep sea, is saturated with hydrogen sulfide, making life impossible. In consequence, all the living organisms, and the fish, huge original stocks of fish, live in the top waters, circulate around the Black Sea. But that was one reason. I was amazed by the existence of this half-dead sea, like no other sea on Earth. And then I was also interested in the history of this sea, which started as a lake. Then it burst out and became a sea, joined the Mediterranean, the primitive Mediterranean. Then it became a lake again. Then once more it burst through into the Mediterranean, broke through the Straits of Constantinople and became a sea, although a strange kind of sea. And it's the memory of some of those huge events which actually are within the memory of human beings, in the sense that if we look at the story of Gilgamesh and the flood, the story of the Bible and the flood, it looks to me as if they are half remembering the catastrophic events which took place around the Black Sea when it suddenly began to rise and overflow its banks. And the second reason was my father. My father was in the Royal Navy, and he served in the so-called intervention, which was the unsuccessful attempt of the United States, Britain, and France, and others to defeat the Bolshevik Revolution and restore the white leadership to power. My father served in the Royal Navy in the Black Sea, and he was a participant as a very young man, he was only 18, in many battles and dramas in Kuban, at Novorossiysk, in Crimea, different places. And he constantly told me extraordinary stories about it. He loved Russia, he learned to speak Russian, and his stories made me want to go and see this for myself. The third reason is that when I was a schoolboy, I got hold of an amazing old book, which was by the great Russian scholar Rostovtsev, and it was called Iranians and Greeks in South Russia. And it described this contact between the great nomad nations like the Scythians and the Sarmatians in the Pontic steppe north of the Black Sea, and the settled Greek colonists around the coast of the Black Sea. And I began to realize that the Black Sea is the place where one of the most important encounters in the history of the human race took place. Because this is where the ideas of civilization versus barbarism were first invented. and the Greeks perceive this. At first, Herodotus, for example, said, well, it's just a difference. It's an extraordinary difference. You know, some people live settled, they have agriculture, they live in houses, towns, they have writing. Others live a completely different life, which has no center, no capital. It isn't settled. You can't conquer it. It's unconquerable. It's limitless. It has infinity about it. And he said, well, they are different, but that doesn't mean that one is better than the other. And Herodotus said, you will find that every people thinks that its own way of living is the best. Now, shortly after that, in the Persian Wars, the Greeks took a different view. They accepted this contrast between civilization and barbarism, but they said this is between good and evil, between progress and backwardness, between light and darkness, and this is a struggle for survival for all that we Greeks hold to be good. So, as one might say, they weaponized the idea of civilization and barbarism, and that distinction has stayed ever since, and it began on the Black Sea.